Oh, hey, hello, how's it going, everyone? Welcome to Rocket League! Oop, there we go. Hey, everyone, welcome to Mitchey Games, welcome to Rocket League. And this is Chaos! And night. Oh! And this is much different than what I used to play. I've been playing a lot of the Snow Day map. I get the new shark fin top there. Whoop! Got a goal. I'm happy with myself today. Gotta be careful how many nanas I do. Because it's either gonna be like jaws or turn to back. Be like, na 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 na. Ripper wheels. Interesting. I don't really care for those. Sure, I'd be up for a rematch. People do it. Yeah. It's like na 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 Batman. Batman. Oh god. I need to like. When I get tired, I say the stupidest things in the world, and it just makes for a comical day. Last couple recordings, I've been having issues with my camera. That was mostly because OBS... I was fiddling with the settings for Undertale, and I forgot to send back, so... I now have Greninja as a new amiibo. And obviously, I got these two beautiful ladies as well. And we're gonna be playing in the rain now. Yeah, we just got one more guy we gotta wait for. And this is the Chaos one. This is eight players, 4v4. So it's a lot of fun. It's a lot more players to deal with. I saw the last game, the score was decently high. I've seen higher scores in 3v3 too, as well though. And definitely the hockey, the Snow Day map. I've seen a lot of stuff. Polar. Let's back it up here. Let's see what we got. I don't know how many more Rocket League videos I do, just because I'm really loving the game right now, so I might just do it until I reason not to. Undertale episodes will continue. I'm just recording on Sunday, and I scored off face off. Just because I actually have time. some stuff on that Saturday. Get a chunk video somewhere. I'm just gonna pump them out and then edit them on Monday. Well, let's demolish. Get some more of that stuff going. I feel like a tuner right now. Ah, you blocked it from going in. And I scored. And I scored. That worked. I think I hit it with the back of the car here. Let's replay that. Nope, I tapped it. I'll look into getting Shovel Knight eventually. It's kind of taking a semi-backseat. I was planning on doing it sooner, but because I'm so far behind Undertale, and I really want to get that. I love it. It's $10. Instead of buying a bunch of more expensive. Token will probably be up on the slate too. Just because. It's a Pokemon company. So I shouldn't have a big issue with Nintendo getting their panties in a bunch about that. I really don't want to do that right now. They're basically. They're doing like a partnership program where it's like you take 40% out, 40% of nothing else. That's what we deal with in the future, which I don't want to deal with that. Anyway, so sorry folks, if you're looking for this kind of content, just not. Too much crap. Maybe in the future. Someone takes very easy for a Let's Play channel. And we get some more solid information. As of now, like, that, again, that's one of the reasons why I stopped doing Devil May Cry. Even if I would have kept doing it as a non-monetized video, I still kind of would have told myself. There's a lot of issues to go on with this. I know there's a couple of people that have been talking about it. Off the channel. And there was a grade. Or I don't know what it is. But he's a huge set of two videos viral. Both channels doing great wonders. I think we will see YouTube find a way to eventually make money on it, as far as internet begins. And there's a lot of arguments as far as they're doing this out. Not, I wouldn't say a loss, but a very minimal gain is what I would put it. People are like, oh, they're not making money. Well, how much of that money are they actually hiding? How much can they say they're not making? It's kind of like saying, I spent $30,000 this year to make $30,000. I didn't really get a ton of money. I can easily say I'm making. They didn't make enough to really call themselves profit. But at the same time, what is it really being profitable? Google hopefully will eventually do stuff again. I think what Google will end up doing is more of a split content, I guess. As far as content that's more professionally made and done will have its own kind of a separate section. And stuff like my content, where it's Let's Plays and a lot of stuff will be section. I wouldn't consider them separate entities at all. And they're kind of doing that now with YouTube Red. They really are looking at that. YouTube Red is kind of starting that. Though, to be completely honest, they're botching it. I'm not looking at... PewDiePie is hilarious in his own right, and I don't watch him a whole lot. I just, his comedy is just different. There's just some comedy I just don't like, and it's nothing like against the comedian or anything like that. But I don't know, the whole like PewDiePie horror thing. Like, this guy started as a Let's Play channel, and he's making horror shows. It makes no sense to what he's doing or what he's about. It makes no sense. Now, something like Netflix, where they're about TVs and movies and they make their own TV shows, that makes sense. If they're already paying for content, you might as well basically let them. Get some fun content that you've made. So I will do. Dang it. I'll do one more match. Why not? Hulu, I think, is the epitome of the devil right now. As far as the. They're doing it all wrong. Yes. There's a now commercial free side of it, but people had to bitch some more to Hulu, which is ridiculous how much fans and viewers had to do. More expensive, like, I think Hulu, like, if you want commercial free, it's like $15. To get, like, all your shows is like $9. Now, like, I get it. I know they're trying to make money on this shit, but
I
just watch it. I watch it when I can. And I usually just watch it when I can. I'm in the TV show as well, man. I dabble in stuff. I mean, people look at me and were like, you're not watching Walking Dead or like Better Call Saul or like Game of Thrones? Like, what is wrong with you? And I just go, that's really all it is. I don't pay for it. I'll pay for what I want. I don't really want TV shows. I don't want video games. Come on. I forgot how like different this is. I forgot soccer's so much different. So with that argument, you know, you're looking at, okay, you pay $15 for commercial free from Hulu, or you pay $8. Amazon is also doing the same Well, okay. Amazon is just kind of they're everything, so they kind of get away with this. They do like I think it's like $60 or $70 subscription. So you're cheap. You run cheaper than Netflix, and you get 2-day ship. I think it's 2-day ship. I think they had to cheat on that. But they also like made a point that they did it because they know it was making money company wise. I don't have any idea. Like, as far as shop, I don't shop on it. So this does not directly affect me, but other people, it will. I think they say the statistics are like huge. It's like those who have a Prime membership spend on average like $600 more than the average Amazon customer. Which is kind of interesting. It's really. Ah! I miss. I thought I didn't use that. So. That's an interesting. Amazon's doing it. I mean, as far as keeping shows and content, some of it will be like obviously part of the membership. And then what is like not part of that membership is a smaller fee for it. There's some movies like people be like, hey, we don't want to do a party subscription. Okay, that's fine. Can we still like put it on our thing and charge them like $10 plus $5? It makes sense. It makes everyone, I think, in the movie industry happy. Everyone still makes money. What else can we talk about? That's fun. Or interest, or information, or just download. Hockey, big trades. Minnesota got rid of their goalie. Anybody that's into hockey, it's kind of somewhat. Big deal. They didn't get rid of their main goalies. They got rid of Nicholas Backstrom, who was their main goalie for the longest time. Got kind of injury prone, I would say, and just kind of never really shined. And Dubnyk and Kemper is kind of. Woo! But. And so they traded Backstrom to Calgary, which is not a bad trade because they're looking for depth as far as the goalie position. I think Ottawa's pretty set on their goalies, if I remember correctly. And we get rid of a huge hit to our cap. We also traded Iowa Wild AHL player Ryan Sutter, coach. His dad is coach for LA Kings, so they traded him to LA, and I think we got like a defenseman and like a couple other things. So Minnesota made some good moves. We're looking to kind of push ourselves back into the playoff hunt. Stocked up on the depth as far as the defense is what we really needed. I think that's what we got. And with the new temporary head coach Torelli, he will be kind of what the Wild will need. Sorry this is a long episode, guys, but the way it kind of worked out that way, it was. I tried to do 15-minute episodes, and it was like dragging on 12. I'm like, it's short, it's too long. So I will leave it here, and as always, have fun playing video games, people. People like to take this, like, serious, like, they want to make a profession out of this, and I'm like, you know, I'm doing this for fun, I'm doing this for fans, I'm doing this for friends. So keep on gaming, keep on having fun, and let's play, everyone. Hey.